Everyone searches for that brass ring in comics. And when I say everyone, I don't mean literally everyone. I know people like to be like, I don't, I'm, you know. In general, right? You guys can argue semantics. In general, everyone is seeking that brass ring. And what I mean by that is as much success as one can garner in fulfilling their dreams of being a comic book star, right? We all want the successful campaigns. We all want our books to sell out at conventions. We all want, you know, positive reviews written on our work and praise. And to say that you don't is a little sus to me. You know, I was watching a stream a little earlier talking about the merits of what makes you a comic book creator. And yes, technically, if you draw some shit and you run it off a Xerox machine and you hand it out to your buddies for $2 a piece and you sell 10 copies, yes, you are a comic book creator by the technical sense of the terms. But that's not what this is about, really, is it? No. This is about being a, you know, an undeniable comic book success, right? And in order to do that, you have to expand your reach. We've heard Tyler Carpenter speak about this a lot, you know, to grow your audience, to, you know, to spread your wings, to soar, to reach for that brass ring. And so, like, you know, in this stream, talking about, yeah, you could go up to a publisher, but why would you when you can do it all yourself? Well, why wouldn't you when you can do both? Right? That's how you actually expand your reach. So, for example, and I'll use me as the example. Why not? I go through Kickstarter and I sell maybe 300 to 400 copies a shot on Kickstarter, right? That's a nice little chunk of money for, you know, small-time comic book creator. You know, you're making anywhere from $15,000 to $25,000 a campaign. Now, mind you, you only really get to keep about half of that. And then, even then, you're still putting pretty much your profits back into making the next book because, well, you know, these things, they're not cheap. It's expensive as hell. Even more expensive now when, you know, the everyday services and goods that we need are rising in price, but we're not making any more money, you know. So it is a lot about money, right? And money comes with success. The two go hand in hand. So when we're reaching for that brass ring, yeah, you could just, you know, do a $5,000 book on Kickstarter and be happy. And no one's telling you not to do that. But if you want more, you're going to have to do more, right, than just do small campaigns on Kickstarter and then call it a day. It has to be more than that. Going with a publisher expands your reach, and I'll tell you why. There's a variety of reasons why. But number one, publishers have name recognition. They have credibility in the industry versus an unknown. You go buy an Image book, you're expecting Image book quality. Hey, you may not always get it, but that's what you're expecting, okay? When you go back an unknown on an indie, God knows what you're actually going to receive in the end. Okay. Price point. When you go through a publisher and people are buying your books in shops, they're paying maybe $3.99, $4.99, maybe a little bit more if it's a thicker book. You go on Kickstarter, you're in for $20 easily, probably in $10 shipping. And that's sort of like your bare bones entry, not buying, you know, digital. You can go digital $5-$6, whatever, no problem. You want physical copies, right? You're not getting them for $4.99 on Kickstarter. And thus, because going through a publisher makes those books more affordable, it means more people are likely to buy it because they can actually afford it in today's crazy economy. You know, when we signed with Antarctic Press, we did, you know, fairly well on Kickstarter, like I said, you know, 300, 400 backer sort of thing. That means, you know, 400 customers. We go publish and put our book in Diamond through Antarctic, and Nyobi Origins has 2,500 copies, right? That has expanded my reach, obviously, right? Not by leaps and bounds. It's from 400 to 2,500. But I'll tell you, you know, they're not paying through the nose for the book. They're able to walk into the shop, look at the shelf, pick up the book, hold it in their hands, peruse, flip through the pages, and not just viewing what it is that we choose to show them on Kickstarter, which is usually the top of the best images that we have, right? More people are aware of what a comic book shop is than they are what Kickstarter is, okay? I know lots of people that buy comics that don't even know what Kickstarter is, and if they do, just couldn't care less of setting up an account and paying what they would consider to be outrageous prices for a comic book they feel should be $5. And I agree with them, but, you know, that's the life we live, right? We have to charge more on Kickstarter because we don't have the advantage of having, you know, the money that Disney has or Warner Brothers has to produce these things in mass volume. Plus, we just don't have the audience to produce them in mass volume. But going with a publisher like an Image or an Antarctic Press or Scout or whoever gives you that opportunity to grow. Okay, that's just one way to grow. You can put your books on Amazon. You can set up your own store, etc., etc., etc. We know the list, right? But I'm talking strictly the merits of being with a publisher in this, reaching for that brass ring of Image Comics in particular. You know, yeah, Image is a club. It's a fraternity. You got to earn your way in. They're not just going to take, you know, Joe average mid comic book creator. They want someone special. They want someone whose work is actually going to make them a profit. They want someone who can sell books. Okay? And that's why they tend to go with more well-known professional names than they do the unknown creator just coming out of the dirt. It's just the way it is. You have to become known, right? And how do you do that? Well, one way to become known is to build up your resume. Again, by going with a smaller publisher, you're now in Diamond. Your name is now in the lexicon. You know, people who are doing unboxing videos and haul videos are picking up your book and talking about it. More people are likely to do reviews because they got the book in the comic shop. And you're not just selling to a Kickstarter collector or a very niche creator crowd. When you're in shops, you're appealing to anyone, honestly, that walks by that shelf and has the potential to see your book. You know, a lot of people got this misconception that you can't do both, right? Like, if you're a publisher, you're not crowdfunding your book. Or if you're crowdfunding your book, you're not really going to chase down a publisher. Well, there's only one answer to that, and it's wrong, okay? Again, lots of publishing companies allow you to keep the rights of your IP and go ahead and kickstart. So, for example, I could go ahead and kickstart Nyobi, maybe make my $20,000, get the book made. And then after that book is made, go ahead and submit it to Antarctic and then make royalties off of that work that's already been done through sales on the comic book shelf and still expand my reach. And the more that we do that, the more that I do that, right, published through Antarctic, the more builds up on my resume. Because anyone can self-publish. That doesn't make you someone special, right? You know, there was talk about legitimacy. Yes, I do think you are more legitimate when a publisher picks you up. And that might be a crazy hot take. But it shows that other people, including a company, is willing to put their business on the line to sell your product and make them money. Yes, that makes you a little bit more legitimate in the professional eyes of the comic book industry, right? And a lot of people coming up through the ranks, I spoke to one guy yesterday on stream, I'll leave his name out of it, but he's a colorist, and he, you know, has ambitions to work for DC. Some people still want to work for the big two and not just produce their own thing, but they will produce their own thing in an effort to build that resume, to build that portfolio, to get to the big two. And many people start with small publishers to get there. For example, The Crow started off in Caliber Comics. Brian Michael Bendis started off in Small Press. A lot of these guys have, okay? And, you know, it's just like being in a, you know, I use wrestling a lot, right? It's like saying, you know, you're comparing Hulk Hogan to the backyard wrestler, right? Yes, technically you're a wrestler, maybe, but you're wrestling in your backyard in front of five people and probably breaking your neck. When Hulk Hogan goes out to 90,000 people in the Pontiac Arena, selling out crowds every time he was on stage in the ring, there's a difference. Both are wrestlers, yes. But one is a professional wrestler being paid professional money, while the other one is an amateur trying to break into the business, right? It's no different in comic books. Right now, if you're self-publishing, you're somewhat of an amateur. You know, you're learning the ropes, you're learning what to do, okay? And you're trying to get to that level, that next level, you know, where you are being published and you are being recognized by your peers and you are being, you know, looked at by, you know, the big three. I would love to do something for Marvel. It's never going to happen, but I would do it. If Marvel said, hey, you want to write some X-Men or some magic for us? And I got to sort of do what I wanted to do? Fuck yeah, I'm in. Right? It's not my goal, but I do it. You know, it's all part about reaching for that brass ring. If I had worked for Marvel and then I put out Nyobi, oh God, Nyobi would sell 10 times the amount. Why? Because I got legitimacy now for being with Marvel, right? That name and brand recognition now attached to my own carries and adds a lot of weight. My suggestion, my advice to creators is this. Yeah, go ahead and put out your stuff, right? Go do your Kickstarters, your Indiegogos, your GoFundMes. Fund my comic. Do it all. You know, go to Amazon, go to Kindle, go to Gumroad, go to eBay, go to whatnot. Whatever it is you got to do to make money, go make your money. But do not underestimate the power of being with a publisher and being distributed in comic book shops as an added bonus to what you're already doing. That only serves to help you and expand your reach. It's not going to hurt you. If no one buys it, fuck, no one buys it. But if no one's buying it, then no one was probably buying it anyway, right? So go ahead and, you know, submit to an AP or a scout or to whoever and get your work circulating in comic book shops where comic book fans go to buy comics. Zell P, stay tuned for our sponsored message. Boom. Boom. If you guessed it and you said, I bet you any money LP is the sponsor of his own video, you would be 100% correct. I am. We are currently crowdfunding Nyobi Penguina number one, the crossover campaign, with 20 days left to go. We're at 178 backers. We have raised $7,356 Canadian dollars, which is about $1.52 US. Maybe enough to get me a cup of coffee. Help me get lunch at McDonald's by, you know, pledging to this campaign. Pick one out of six great covers we got to choose from. It is a 30-page book where Nyobi teams up with her good friend, Penguina, to go on an epic classic superhero adventure. It's a book you don't want to miss.